and welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at the allylic system. So I have drawn before us the simplest molecule that would contain an allylic carbon. So basically, you're talking about the next door neighbor carbon to a pi bond. So this would be the allylic position on this particular molecule. And these protons here could be described as allylic protons. The double bond next door is sometimes referred to as a vinyl group, and so you might see the protons that are on the actual double bond referred to as vinylic protons. Okay, so the allylic position is the position adjacent to a pi bond. So one of the reasons we make a distinction about the allylic position, the position right next door to the pi bond, is that the reactivity of that position is often increased because of the possibility of resonance structures for intermediates that are generated. So if we think about this bromine group, that could leave, and if it does, that would generate this carbocation here, plus bromide floating around in solution. But that carbocation is not localized on only that carbon because of the pi bond next door. It's an allylic carbocation. So these electrons could fold over, and that would give us this resonance contributor here. So that charge is delocalized across two carbon atoms, and that stabilizes that intermediate, and it would increase the rate of the reaction because of this stabilization. Now, the actual structure of that intermediate is a weighted average of those two, right? So if I would draw a dotted line to show pi bond character across those three carbons with partial positive charges located on the end carbon and then that third carbon in. So if I numbered this, 1, 2, 3, just for keeping track, not for naming, you can see that in my two Lewis structures that have resonance contributors, I have a charge localized at carbon 1 and carbon 3. The actual molecule is a weighted average of that, but the delocalization of the charge stabilizes the carbocation intermediate. And that delocalization is possible because the leaving group was at the allylic position. The stabilization by the allylic system is not just possible for carbocations, but also for other intermediates, including radicals and anions. So just to illustrate, there's a radical on the right-hand side of my molecule for this top molecule there. And so remember, when I'm pushing arrows for radicals, I use single-headed arrows because you're moving one electron at a time. So I draw my other resonance contributor. So my arrows have said that now the pi bond is there and the radical is there. The overall character of that molecule, just like the one we just drew, is partial radical character at those two positions. But the spreading out of that unpaired electron across a pi system is going to stabilize it. And again, it's possible because it's at the allylic position. For a negative charge, we'd see the same thing. You've got a negative charge adjacent to a pi bond, so it's at the allylic position. Those electrons can fold over and kick the pi bond out so as to not break the octet rule. And that would give us this structure. And again, the overall character is pi bond character across those three carbons, in this case with a partial negative charge at the end and at that central carbon, from what we can see from our resonance structures. So we have a radical intermediate and also an anion intermediate that are stabilized by the presence of the pi bond next door. Lastly, I just want to address that you may see simple allylic systems referred to by their common name, which is allyl, and then whatever the group next door is. So on the left-hand side here, I would have allyl bromide, and we would call the alcohol allyl alcohol. So this is the simplest allylic system I could have, three total carbons, right? You've got the pi bond and then the allylic position next door. So allyl bromide tells me that I have a bromine at the allylic position. Allyl alcohol tells me that I have an alcohol at the allylic position. So this has been a look at allylic systems and a little introduction to them. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.